Jain. It is my pleasure to see you after a long time. And I'm so happy to see your growth in a very short span. Could you please tell us something about Time Technoplast and its growth?
Well, thank you very much for seeing us. As you know that I'm a great supporter of modern plastic. We've been circulating it within the group for a very long time. You do a splendid job. It's in fact my pleasure to meet you. Time Technoplast is just completed 25 years and it's been a long journey. Starting in 1992 with a very small capital, we have been able to grow our business over a period of time. We have expanded both in India and have also gone overseas. Currently, we are present in 12 countries. In fact, industrial packaging was the business that we started with, and subsequently, we expanded to other polymer products, and both of them are really working very, very well. In fact, if you look back last 10 years, we have got a CAGR of 20% per annum, and I believe we should be able to maintain that in the coming years as well.
It is the Indian plastic industry is growing rapidly, and what kind of growth or what kind of Indian plastic growth you expect in the coming years, and what are the changes people need to do to improve our growth?
Well, as we clearly know that as the GDP grows, the use of polymer actually grows rapidly from there. In fact, the polymer growth had been higher than the GDP growth worldwide. But considering the fact that the per capita consumption of polymers in India is extremely low as compared to the peers in Asia and around, we have a lot of gap to bridge. We expect that in coming days, the growth of this sector will be tremendous. As we heard the other day, we are right now at 2.5 trillion economy, and then it's going to be about 7 trillion in next 10 years' time. That would mean there is going to be tremendous growth, and considering the fact that we already have an area in terms of per capita consumption of polymers, I expect that the polymer industry will grow leaps and bounds.
As of now, there are so many banned plastics coming up in many states. What do you think? How we can change the situation, or how we can improve on these environmental issues?
Well, I think most of the objection to the polymers is coming because of the ignorance. If you look at it, polymers, if used properly, can actually save the environment tremendously. I can give an example. Today, if you take polymer as a replacement for metal, it takes 4 times the energy for 1 kg of metal to be produced as compared to polymers. And in terms of weight, the polymers are about 2.2 to 2.5 times more. That would actually mean that the energy equation is 1:11. And considering the fact that the polymers can actually be used 3 times over by recycling, we are talking about energy equation of 1:33. Now, I see no reason why anybody should be having an objection to polymers if they are concerned about the environment. Yes, I do agree that there have been some mismanagement in terms of certain products. I think the most important thing that we have to really work on is the recycling industry in the country and the collection facilities. Right now, that is not present, but I am sure with new developments, we would be seeing a recycling industry coming up and the problem with polymers will be completely gone. Let me tell you, polymers are here to stay and they will grow rapidly. I see no reason why the environmentalist will have any objection to use of polymers in new areas.
Please tell us about your global presence and what are your expansion planning?
Well, we started our global journey about 10 years ago when we first had put up a factory in UAE, and then from there we went over to the other Asian countries, starting from Taiwan, we are in Vietnam, Thailand, Malaysia, also in Indonesia. And then we moved towards west. So we now actually have a factory in Bahrain and also in Egypt. Just about 4 weeks ago, we actually have moved in. We have bought our competitor in Saudi Arabia as well. Well, having assumed leadership in this area, we now are trying to expand further onto the Western world. We shall soon be seen in Germany. We are setting up a factory in a place called Dortmund in Germany, and we'll also be putting up a factory in Ohio and Chicago in the United States.
So how do you plan to expand? What may be the investment you are going to do in different countries?
Well, we are expecting to add 2 countries every year. Of course, we are expanding in the countries that we are present. We are putting up additional production facilities. And I guess this will continue because we have got a lot of areas to cover. In terms of capital investment, as you know, we have a robust cash flow coming in from our operations. So we are going to be engaging that for expansions. Our expansions don't require a major investment. Therefore, we should be able to sustain that from our internal resources only.
What is the secret behind this?
Well, as you know, that the competition brings the best out of you. And we have been seeing our competitors and we have moved ahead of them. I think the philosophy that we follow is that it is not enough that you are actually just ahead of your competitors. The idea is that you should be so far ahead that you are not able to see them.
You have received so many recognitions and awards. What is the secret behind this?
Well, I must say that these rewards belong to the people who work in this company. If you look at the baseline of the company, we say that there are 3 things which are common to everything that we do. That is polymer, technology and innovation. And these awards actually represent excellence in all the 3 areas.
Sir, there are so many developments happen, everything goes growing on a higher scale, rapid growth. What message you want to give it to the Indian plastic industry and the upcoming entrepreneurs?
Well, I'm convinced that the future of polymer industry in this country is great. First of all, we have got a lot of latent demand which needs to be tapped. Fortunately for us, the polymer producers have taken a leap of faith for the industry and have set up new capacities. So the availability of polymers is going to be easier in coming years. In addition to that, we have got great institutions who are generating excellent professionals and specialists in polymer products. Therefore, we don't have to depend upon people from outside. We have got local talent that is available. And on top of it, the government policies are very much in favor of the industry to grow. As we have seen recently, there is special incentives that are being given to the medium industry. And I think all these factors put together will help in rapid growth of this industry. I'm convinced that the future of this industry is very, very bright.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for being with Modern Plastics India and Modern Plastics TV. We wish you all the best for Time Technoplast, growing further ahead, expanding to new horizons. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure talking to you. I'm sure Modern Plastic will do extremely well in this country because the content of that is excellent. And I'm sure the industry will be able to take full benefit of the information that is provided there. Thank you.